On 1st September, we commemorate one of the brightest stars in the Carmelite order of the 18th century, St. Teresa Margaret of the Sacred Heart, born Anna Maria Redi in Arezzo in Tuscany in 1747. Her family was of the lower nobility of the time and moderately wealthy. She was the second of 13 children, all of whom, except the firstborn and the fifth, who died as children, consecrated themselves to God. Anna was well-mannered and refined, simple and innocent, quiet and unassuming, but could be vivacious and on occasion somewhat mischievous. Overall, she had a very happy childhood and was outstanding for her inclination towards piety, desire for sanctity, and compassion for the poor. When she was 9, she became a boarder in St. Apollinaris College of the Benedictine Nuns of Florence, where she received a meticulous education from 1756 to 1763. After making a few spiritual retreats at age 14, she became a lovable, responsible, and affable child. She felt called to the religious life and considered entering the Benedictines. Her vocation to Carmel was revealed to her when, saying goodbye to a friend who was entering Carmel, she heard in her heart these words, "I am Teresa of Jesus, and I want you among my daughters." Distressed and upset, she fled to the tabernacle, where she again heard the voice saying, "I am Teresa of Jesus, and I tell you, in a short time you will be in my monastery." Anna felt she had a vocation to be a Carmelite, which she had not considered before. She left college to allow her decision to mature. When she became 17, she made her decision known, much to the surprise of everyone and the displeasure of the nuns of her college. She entered the discussed Carmelite nuns in Florence for trial period on 1st September 1764. A short while before finishing her postulancy, she had an operation on her knee and left the convent, not knowing if she would be readmitted. She re-entered and took the habit on 10th March 1765, deciding to live in prayer, obedience, and silence. She was professed on 12th March 1766 and took the name of Teresa Margaret of the Heart of Jesus. She was given a special contemplative experience of the words of St. John, "God is love," and she lived in fidelity to this experience by a hidden life of love and self-gift. She had a great devotion to Christ crucified, the captain of love who held high the standards of the cross. She made a resolution in 1758 to be motivated only by love and the will of God. She was often heard to exclaim, "God is love." Her love of God was powerfully expressed in her love for her sisters, to whom she gave herself in dedication and service. She was exquisite in exercising charity from the beginning. She offered to take care of the old and sick, in whom she saw Jesus Christ, and she was assistant to the infirmarian. Those who were sick asked for her, and she offered to take care of the more difficult ones, including a sister who was suffering from dementia and was aggressive and whom everyone feared. But Teresa Margaret knew how to cope with her with great patience and without complaining. True to the tradition of the order, Teresa Margaret was utterly devoted to Our Lady, whom she regarded as her model and protectress. She died from appendicitis at the age of 32 on 7th March 1770, and her incorrupt body is venerated at the Carmelite Monastery in Florence. She was beatified by Pope Pius XI on 9 June 1929 and canonized by the same Pope on 19th March 1934. Placing all our petitions before her today, let us pray. Lord God, you enable St. Teresa Margaret Redi to draw untold sources of humility and charity from the fountainhead, our Saviour. Through her prayers, may we never be separated from the love of Christ. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.